Good morning, kids of the kingdom. How are you doing? Welcome to another online service. I hope you're keeping cool, because we have a cool kids of the kingdom service for you today. So let's get going. Josiah, my son, is going to pray us in.
Father in heaven, we just pray for these people who are watching. We just pray that you just bless them. And if anything is going on in their family, just bless them and take whatever, any bad things in their life, just go away forever. And just please help this service to go really good and that nothing bad will happen. Thank you for all these people watching. Amen.
Amen. Okay, so remember, as always, we sent your curriculum out to your parents, guardians yesterday. With some discussion questions that maybe you'll be able to share at a family time and discuss those questions together, and other questions that might arise through today's service. Okay, so right now we're going to go with Mr. Jody. Woo! Here's Mr. Jody, and he's going to lead us with his thought with some worship. Okay, bye. We'll see you soon.
Hello, kids of the kingdom. It's Mr. Jody and
Jalen,
my eldest daughter, and Charlie, the dog. And he's gonna lay down right there. And Jackson here too. And Annabelle, we have a guest. Say hi.
Hi.
Yeah, we have a guest. This makes this a studio audience. That's pretty cool. Let's do some worship. Lord God, we come before you, thankful, humble, and hungry for more of you. God, open our eyes and let us see the blessings all around us. And Jalen said,
amen.
She did, she said it. You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope. Restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. It's your breath. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise. We pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs. Pour out our praise to you, only. Great are you, Lord. You give life, you are love. Bring light to the darkness. You give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. It's your breath in our lungs. We pour out our praise. Pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise.
Your praise, our hearts will cry, these bones will sing.
All the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing. Great I know, 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 great I know. From my breath I sing, great I know, great I know. I know it's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise, we pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise to you only. Great are you, Lord. Sing, great are you, Lord, one more time. Shadow, it won't light up. Mountain, you won't climb up. Coming after me. War, you won't kick down. Lie, you won't tear down. Coming after me. Holy, you're the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down. Fights till I'm found. These nine. I couldn't earn it, I don't deserve it. Still you take myself away. Holy, overwhelming, never ending, reckless love of God. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That was good.
Before I spoke a word, you were singing over me. You have been so, so good to me. Before I took a breath, you breathed your life in me. You have been so, so good. Overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down, fights till I'm believes in 99. I couldn't earn it, I don't deserve it. Still you give yourself away. God.
$9.99. I couldn't earn it, I don't deserve it. Still you give yourself away. Oh, the overwhelming, ever-ending, reckless love of God. Show you a light, a mountain you'll climb, coming after me. War you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. Shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. The war you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. Oh, the overwhelming, ever ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down, fights till I'm found. These are 99. I couldn't earn it, I don't deserve it. Still you give yourself away. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God.
Lord God, I just thank you that you chase us down as kids and as grown-ups. You chase us down and love on us. God, just remind us of that simple truth, that no matter what, you will always chase us down. And all of God's kids said,
amen.
Stick around, Mr. Kinney's up next.
Kids of the Kingdom, how are you all doing? Welcome to another online service. I hope you're all doing really well, and I hope you're keeping cool, because today we're going to continue our journey through the Sermon on the Mount. And today we're going to look at a topic called To Be Seen by God and Not by Man. And we're going to look at Matthew chapter 6, verses 1 to verse 4. I'll let me read the text. Be careful not to practice your righteousness in front of others, to be seen by them. If you do, you have no reward from your Father in heaven. So when you give to the needy, do not announce it with trumpets at the synagogue or on the streets as the hypocrites do, to be honored by others. Truly, I tell you, they have their reward in full. But when you give to the needy, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your giving may be in secret. Then your Father, who sees what is done in secret, will reward you. In these verses, Jesus is talking about giving to others and not making a big deal about the giving and making a spectacle as we practice righteousness. However, if you look at 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 7, it tells us that that we are to give cheerfully or with a cheerful heart. Now, the word cheerful in that verse means hilariously. We are to give hilariously, which means we do, or we are, you know, encouraged to give hilariously, merrily, or righteously. But when when we think about what Jesus is saying right now, it's kind of like, what do you mean? Because you're saying, don't let your left hand know what your right hand is doing. Do it in secret. But if you're giving hilariously, it's going to be really hard. It's going to be really hard for people not to see that. I mean, after all, giving can be a good thing. And if you're giving hilariously, merrily, with a joyful heart, cheerfully, then it's going to encourage people that see that to also give merrily, joyfully, hilariously, cheerfully, okay? And really, Jesus was not saying that it's wrong to give in public. He was talking about the motive behind the giving. Okay? And here is the reason why. In Jesus' day, the spiritual leaders would make sure that they gave in a way that others would see their giving. Okay? They would want people to see what they're doing. It was a spectacle. They made a big spectacle out of their giving. They made it into a big event. It was like a big show. They would have a parade and they would blow trumpets. Look at me, I'm giving to the poor. Here you are, okay? They wanted people to know that they were holy people because they gave to the poor, okay? That's what they wanted to do. But the gifts were not really out of a joyful heart, but from a heart of pride, because they wanted to get man's acceptance. They wanted to get that pat on the back. Well done, you've gave a lot of money today, which is good to give. But really, the whole desire behind the giving was to get recognition. Now, Jesus gave some different instructions about giving. He wants us to do it from a joyful and merry heart. He wants us to give hilariously. He said, do not give in a way that makes people look at you and think that you're special. Don't give in a way that, you know, you want people to look at you. Oh, there's a very special person. They're giving to the poor. Oh, they must be really, really holy. He said, avoid that. Do not give so people think that you're better than everybody else. That's what he was saying, right? He said that when you give with those kind of motives to be seen by others, then you have your reward right there. That's your reward. The praises of men. The reward of man, that pat on your back. That's your reward. Jesus encourages disciples, actually encourages us, with the fact that there's a better reward. There's a better reward when you give with an hilarious heart or you give joyfully. It's a reward that comes from, what we see our Father God do. When he sees generosity, it means that we're imitating him and we've got his heart and we've picked it up and we're doing what we've seen him do. Hey kids, I also tell you this. You can never, ever outgive God the Father. You see, our Father loves to give good gifts to his children. He wants to shower us with good gifts. Now, here's an example of an amazing gift that God the Father gave us. And it's Jesus Christ, his Son. And it says in the scripture that it pleased God to bruise his Son, which means it pleased God to give us Jesus, that he would die for us, that we might be called sons and daughters of God. Now, just as it pleased the Father to give his Son for us, he wants us to give joyfully with a pure heart. He wants us to be pleased to give to others. I want it to be, and it pleased us to give to people. Give hilariously and joyfully. Now listen, kids. Giving hilariously with a pure heart is the Father's heart revealing us. Let me say that. Giving hilariously with a pure heart is the Father's heart revealed in us. And this is very pleasing to the Father. As I've said a few minutes ago, we are imitating him. So when you give with a joyful heart, a merry heart, only to be seen by the Father and not to be seen by others. Now remember, God loves a cheerful giver because that kind of giving comes from what is going on the inside of us, okay? It's because we've been made glad. Because we have Jesus living inside of us. We have the Holy Spirit prompting us. That's the kind of giving. It's a wonderful representation of how God gave his only son as we give to others in need. So today's lesson is this. Seek the Father first, okay? Seek God's favor first. The Apostle Paul, in his letter to the Galatians, says this: do not think I am trying to get the favor of men or God. If I were still trying to please men, I would not be a servant owned by Christ. I'm just doing what my heart tells me to do. I'm doing the prompt as the Holy Spirit prompts me. I'm just doing what I see God do and what I'm told to do. As we live out our lives as children of the kingdom, let's be more concerned about what the Father thinks about us than what other people think about us. Don't worry what the world's got to think about you. Be more worried about what God's got to think about you. And this, when you give hilariously. Let your heart be glad like God's heart. And give the way you have seen him give. Give the way that he gave you. The way you saw him give you. Give that same way. 2 Corinthians 9:7, we've talked about it. It tells us, let it spring up freely from the joy of giving, all because God loves hilarious generosity. Okay? God loves hilarious generosity. So let it spring up freely from the joy of giving, all because God loves hilarious generosity. And the last thing I want to leave you with is, and be assured of God's reward, okay? Because God can outgive all of us, and he will. You can outgive God. Deuteronomy 15:10 says, give generously to the poor, not grudgingly, for the Lord your God will bless you in everything you do. You know, we know, we cannot outgive God. It does not matter how much we give God. If we're giving with a pure heart, he will see that and he will give and just keep on giving and just keep on giving. He'll keep blessing us and blessing us and blessing us. The more we give hilariously and with a pure heart, the more God's going to bless us. Let me read that last verse again. Give generously to the poor, not grudging, for the Lord your God will bless you in everything you do. Your Lord your God will bless you in everything you do. Okay, guys, so that's all I've got time for today. But don't go away, we've still got some more stuff going on. Okay, we'll see you soon. God bless you. Okay, bye.
Good morning, kids of the kingdom. So I have a fun object lesson for you today. It's kind of a little bit of a skit, and we hope that you guys will enjoy it and it will help you just think about what it is to be cheerful givers. So I have a few questions for you. What do you guys think that it means to be rich? You can just kind of answer yourselves at home, since I can't hear you from where I'm at. Do you think that someone can be rich even though they don't have very much money? Do you think that someone with lots of money can be poor? Today, I have two short stories about two very different people. One had lots of money and the other was very poor. We'll learn how God wants us to be cheerful givers, because giving, whether it's giving of our time or giving of our money, is an act of worship when we do so with the right attitude. Have you ever had a hard time sharing something that you really love? Maybe it was your favorite toy, hard to share. Maybe it was your favorite video game, kind of hard to share that. Or maybe it's even your favorite snack, whatever that might be. Sometimes those things are hard to share. How did it make you feel to give up something that you like, even if it was for just a little short time? Did you do so cheerfully, or did you whine and complain about it? So we're going to hear two stories about how God loves when we give with a cheerful heart. So remember, God loves cheerful givers. So the first story comes from the book of Mark in the New Testament. So the story is about a rich young man who comes to Jesus. Come on in, guys. So we have a rich young man who comes to Jesus and he asks, "What do I need to do to have eternal life?" Jesus, and that sounds like a great question, doesn't it? Jesus told the man that he must follow the Ten Commandments. The man responds that I've obeyed all of God's commands. So Jesus says, there's one other thing that you must do. You must go and sell everything that you own and give your money to the poor. When the man heard this, he went away from Jesus feeling sad. So why do you think that the man was sad? Well, this man had a lot of money. And he loved being rich. And Jesus knew that in his heart, the man didn't want to share what he had. His heart was not cheerful at the thought of giving up what he had. In fact, he loved his wealth more than he loved God. Remember, God loves cheerful givers. God doesn't want us to be sad when we give to him. He wants us to have happy hearts because giving to God is one way that we worship him. Our next story is about a woman who was very happy to give to God. So a little while later in the book of Mark, we read that Jesus was in the temple with his disciples. And from where they were sitting, they could see the offering box and watched as people came to give their offerings. They saw very rich men put in many gold coins. And then they saw an old woman come. And here's a fishy-looking old woman. And all she could put in was 2 copper coins, 2 pennies. When they saw the woman, Jesus said something amazing. Mark 12:43, Jesus says this, "I tell you the truth, this poor widow has put in more into the treasury than all the others." But the disciples were amazed. "But Jesus," they said, "she only put in 2 gold coins. That's not nearly as much as those men who put in many gold coins." But Jesus told her, "Those men, they gave out of their wealth. But this woman, she gave out of her poverty. She put in everything that she had, all that she had to live on." Not only did the woman give everything that she had, but she did so with a cheerful heart. She wasn't worried that she wouldn't have enough money to live on. She trusted that God would provide all that she needed. The woman worshiped God by giving generously and with a happy heart. Remember, God loves a cheerful giver. God loves it when we give generously too, boys and girls. The problem is that our hearts naturally cling to all the stuff in our lives. We want to hang on to it and keep it for ourselves. We would rather have things than God, if we're being honest. But the good news is that we serve a generous God who wants to make us more like him. Did you know that God has given us the greatest gift ever? God gave his very life to save us from our sins. He sent his son Jesus to live a perfect life and die on the cross so that we could be forgiven and live with God forever. Did God whine and complain when he gave up his own life for us? No way! God loved us so much that he gave himself willingly and cheerfully. And now, when we trust Jesus to save us, God gives us generous and cheerful hearts to give to him out of worship for him. All right, guys, that was it for today. See you next week. Ha ha ha!
you're calling me. When faith is lost and my hope exhausted, you will be my strength.
Yeah.
watch the darkness slip away. Put your power on display. Say goodbye to fear and shame.
Okay, that's it for today. We hope you enjoyed the service. Remember, we did send the curriculum to your guardians, your parents, with some discussion questions for you to discuss as a family or any other questions that might arise. Okay, well, we're going to see you next week, so Caleb's going to pray us out and that'll be done.
Dear Father in Heaven, we thank you for this time we've had to fellowship with you and to learn your word. Now, as we go, we pray that you would please pour out your blessings upon us and teach us more through what we remember from this, Lord. In your glorious name we pray. Amen.
Okay, so thank you again. We will see you next week. Have a great week. Have some fun. And stay safe. And stay warm. Cool. Not warm. It's too warm. But stay cool. All right. Okay, God bless you guys. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Ha ha ha!